Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue the eating streak here in the Binding of Isaac Invicta Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you everybody for supporting the like streak. We have begun a new one. So let's just keep going. I mean, there's no other witty comment I have other than that. Seed day is going to be Pies F8 Whiskey Juliet. We've got just god-awful tears rate, but because we have Inner Eye, good damage, of course, and average move speed, but we also, even more excitingly than that, have freaking Crack the Sky. Let's go. Oh, man. So, really quickly, there will not be a RimWorld episode today before I forget to announce everybody, because I have been busy literally all day today getting ready for, well, not getting ready for, but doing all the upped production stuff that I was talking about for the Isaac tournament yesterday. So RimWorld will be back tomorrow. So and also concurrently, the tournament will be beginning on Wednesday. So I just didn't get enough done today, but I got all the parts in. I have all the parts in place. Today was going to be the hardest part, which was creating everything from scratch again. So basically, the long story short, I had about 3 hours worth of work into like basic thumbnails. It really wasn't anything special. But after a lot of consideration yesterday night, I decided that I wanted to just up the production quality and the production values of the tournament. I ended up going overboard, as I always do with it, but I kind of knew that was going to happen. So unfortunately the tournament will be starting slightly later, 48 hours later than I originally intended, but hopefully everyone's okay with that. And yeah, all I can say is that I will make sure it's worth everyone's while to wait for the extra 2 days. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Now, let's talk about this run here. Okay, there's a barrel right there. All right. What the hell just happened? We walked into this room with one soul heart. We are leaving with zero soul hearts. Okay, so Curse of Darkness completely concealed that barrel, like, next to us here. There was a barrel here. You can't even see it. Like, and it's even darker for you guys than it is for me, but, like, yeah. So I hit that barrel, and then there was another barrel here, which I couldn't get past. And we actually lost the iframes right before that barrel went off, and that took the other HP away, so... Yeah, we also have Zodiac, which is the item that we picked up on the first floor. Zodiac is going to give us a random, Zodiac item. So as you can see here, thanks to the horns and to our increasing movement speed, we have proc'd Taurus for this floor. And Zodiac will change that effect on every floor. So it's possible you could get the same effect two floors in a row. Unlikely, but it is possible. You can also get Libra, yes. In case you were wondering. Tough love, whatever. I mean, our luck chance is positive, so I can't really feel too bad about that. But Tough Love is usually, it just adds on a little bit of extra DPS, so every now and then you'll see Isaac, being on your luck stat, will shoot out this tooth that shoots out, let's see if I can show you that right there, that molar. And essentially what it does is that tooth, if it hits the target, would deal basically double damage. If you crack the sky... Now, I do want to get a full charge here for the boss. I pretty much had to use Crack the Sky. I cannot talk tonight. I was, like, streaming the entire editing process today, and that was a lot of talking against my better judgment and also probably doctor's orders if I was going to see a doctor. Okay, there's just going to be nothing here. All right, I guess we'll just go... I mean, do we really need to buy a full charge? If it's Ragman, I'm going to be upset. Let's see what's in the store. Well, it's a moot point because there's no full charge, so Ace of Clubs. All right, well, that was totally not worth it. Would love to get Hive Mind if possible. Yes, I could have used the Ace of Clubs to turn those into bombs, but... Say lovey. Larry Jr., it's actually Champion Larry Jr., which is the more annoying one. So we're going to be very cautious here. Now, obviously, I could just play it safe and wait for Taurus to kick in. Oh, by the way, before I forget, yesterday's run. Yes, once again, I fell victim to not remembering that I could have taken Juice of Shadow, killed myself outside of the Devil Deal, and then respawned back in it. That is a consistent problem that I have remembering that sort of thing. So I know it frustrates people. Again, all I can say is just that it's just something that I don't think about. But it's a very good strategy to use, for sure. To be sure, smarter players and better players than I will not forget that. But it's not a strategy I ever really had to employ all that much, so that's the reason. That's my excuse, and I'm sticking to it. So we get the Pact, of course, and Guppy's Hairball. Guppy's Hairball is going to give us a little bit of an Orbital. It's not really that reliable, but it's okay. And then, oh, apparently we procced a Scorpio here as well. So Scorpio's going to give us some poison damage on this floor, which is nice. But before you think it's like better than Serpent's Kiss, it doesn't. Scorpio actually does not give you Soul Hearts, unfortunately, for killing a poisoned enemy. It would have been nice, but then there's really no need for Serpent's Kiss at that point. Then the Pact, of course, is just going to be a huge tears up and damage up as well. It's not really like huge, but it's a good all-around damage upgrade, because not only do you get tears, but you also get two Soul Hearts, and you get a damage upgrade. It's a mild damage upgrade, but it's an overall DPS upgrade. So we're just going to plow through here and should be okay. Absolutely crushed the like streak yesterday. I appreciate that, everyone. Yes, I will take Epiphora. This is one of the few times that you would consider taking Cursed Eye if you have Inner Eye or if you have Mutant Spider. Also known as Quad Shot. I like to call it Quad Shot just because it's easier. Are you a wizard? Not exactly what I was looking for, but Epiphora is going to be that item that as long as we're firing in the same direction, it will increase our tears rate up to a certain point. And once we change our fire trajectory, it will reset it back to normal. And as you saw right there, Dark One didn't have any, he didn't stand any chance against Crack the Sky, which is the reason why Crack the Sky is amazing. Unfortunately, we cannot open any of those chests, and we also don't have any, well, keys, so I can't even get into the item room if I wanted to right now. Now, a bad habit that I find myself getting into with Epiphora is I try to force the direction of my tears too much. Like, instead of doing the logical thing, which is just like simply, you know, being on a swivel and oscillating my shots whenever I need to towards my target, I tend to be like, oh, I'm just going to keep, I don't want to lose our tears rate, so I'm just going to keep on firing in this one direction over and over again. Like when it's nonsensical to do so. Thank you for dunking yourself in the fire, I appreciate that. Now, I would like to go into the double room first. Okay. Well then, hello, Juice of Shadow, how you doing? What am I doing? You literally just found that secret room here. You know it's not going to be attached there, you dingbat, you dingus. So we get Juice of freaking Shadow, which is going to respawn us as Black Judas, which I know that a lot of people are going to love, because we haven't had enough Black Judas in our lives. But I mean, let's be honest. Is Black Judas one of the best items in the game? I mean, yeah, I think it is. And if you recall, for those of you who are interested in the tournament, if you recall, Juice's Shadow has to go up against Soy Milk. And a lot of people seem to think that Soy Milk is just going to get completely run over. I don't know, man. I think you're not giving Soy Milk enough credit where credit's due. Soy Milk has some pretty insanely powerful combos. Now, that being said, of course, so does Juice's Shadow. But I don't think it's going to be that much of a runaway steal. A runaway matchup, as some people I've seen in the comments predict. Juice of Shadow, but that won't even happen until next month, or next week, I should say, not next month. The tournament will be over in a month. This isn't really worth diplopying. So let's take. Dude, this curse the maze, man. Let's take Diplopia to the Devil Deal to see what we can get, because we don't have a whole lot of HP to give, although we do want to turn into Black Judas, like, on this floor if possible. And it's an end. Trying to take it one shot at a time here, game. Apparently there's another one somewhere. Okay. So anyway, I'm going to take Diplopia. We should try to turn into Black Judas on this floor, if possible. I'm kind of upset that, like, Curse the Maze shuffled that freaking statue room right in front of the store. Like, we have to get back in the store. I'm not losing Cracked Sky. Not that we're going to need it, of course, but... And again, yes, my voice is still going out. I apologize about that. We actually did the football podcast today on Monday, which is not the usual recording day, but... It's because Coach Crendor was not going to be able to record tomorrow, and neither was I, because I had to do all the tournament stuff with my special guest, who I've not named yet. Some people were speculating, and that's what I like to see. Big-time plays and such. But all will be revealed soon. TM, soon. Not going to worry about Stained here, and of course we don't get a deal with the devil, because why would we? Okay, so we're going to kill ourselves here. I would like to go into the store, or into the, yeah. Yeah, so I'm going to take this key. And let's just go see what's inside of this double locked door here. Let's see what's inside this double locked door here, and it's Eternal Chest. You get some money. Unfortunately, I already used Diplopia, but hey, you know, whatever. Alright, and then was there an arcade in this floor? We didn't actually go see that. And I really would like to like to open up those golden chests. Even if it's just one of them to steal it, because we're going to respawn as Black Judas on this floor. That's happening. That is just happening. Okay, so there's no arcade that we can see. Unless there's a sacrifice room down here, which I would like to see. Did it on purpose, by the way. Oh, we have Virgo on this floor, apparently. Neat. Okie dokie. Well, we could open up one of these golden chests, at least. Maybe it'll have another key in it, maybe? No, sacks, whatever. Okay. Why in the world did we spawn back there? Oh, I guess because it was the last active room that we were in. Okay, anyway. So this floor was a pretty big wash. We didn't really get much of anything. Yo, curse the maze. Curse of the maze, though. Seriously. We've gone backwards. And, like, I'm pretty sure that we've been shuffled at least 10 times on this floor alone. We just get to do this room again. Oh, what is this? Stars card. Okay. I'll take the stopwatch just so people stop worrying about me not taking the stopwatch. Look, someone tried to bring up the point. They acted like they were making a really good point. They're like, oh, he doesn't want to take the stopwatch because it's OP, but then he takes Mob's knife. It's like, yeah, they're two completely different things. Mom's knife actually has variation. You can use it for a variety. I mean, there's many different synergies with Mom's knife. That could be fun and interesting, and really just change up, you know, how the game goes. The stopwatch doesn't do that. The stopwatch only serves as one function, and that function is just to make the game, like, ridiculously easy. And because I addressed this in the last couple of episodes, the reason being, for me anyway, I'm only speaking from my point of view, that I don't take it is because it's just out of force of habit. In Vanilla Isaac, and even in Rebirth, before it got nerfed, I'm just used to not taking it. But I'll never, like, not take Mom's Knife if we need it. If we need it. The Eternal Heart here, I will go ahead and go for that since Sunny Depths 1. I'm going to use the Stars card so we can actually go in and steal Boss Rush. We don't really need HP right now. Jar of Flies is good, but is it better than Crack the Sky good? I don't think so. Look, I'm just looking for a Yave game. Okay, well, I'll take a credit card, but I still want a Yave. You don't understand. I want a key. Okay, well, that works, I guess. Credit card's gonna give us everything for free. And this that also works on Devil Deals, by the way. You did not know. You can use a credit card and completely negate the heart cost for items, which is awesome. It's a neat little tip. We get the golden, why do we have, oh, you know what? We have Sagittarius. I was like, why does it look like we have piercing shot? We have Sagittarius. That makes sense. Thank you, Zodiac. I wish we actually had piercing shots. But the golden question mark is going to give us a double item room from here on out. Now, unfortunately, we only have one floor left of, like, actual items, but what the stopwatch does, by the way, for those of you wondering, like, well, why does everyone make a big stink about the stopwatch? Well, if Isaac takes damage while he has the stopwatch, everything moves as if it's in a perma state of slow. Everything moves at, like, 50% speed, including, but not limited to, projectiles, enemy movement, spawning, you know, that sort of thing. So it makes the game really, really freaking easy. And as a tip for those of you who are newer players, or if you find yourself struggling with achievements, that sort of thing, and you're looking for an easy way to beat Hush, just get the stopwatch. The stopwatch hard counters Hush to like no other. Go in, immediately dunk Brownie. See you later. Oh, he's gonna forget it. He's gonna forget to go to the item room. No. Come on, son. Who do you think you're talking to? This ain't my first time around the rodeo, if you know what I mean. Yeah, so this is what the stopwatch does. Slows down everything, makes it super easy and boring. Not boring, but it's too easy, you know? I can't monologue on a game that's too easy. And, okay. Just looking for that item room. And luck would have it, it would be the one spot we didn't go check. It's always in the place... whatever you're looking for is always in the place that took the longest to get to in Isaac. That's basically what we've learned across 400 and whatever, how many episodes in Afterbirth Plus. The mark's going to be damage, movement speed, and a soul heart, which paid for us getting into that curse room. We don't really need that chest here. we don't really need that chest hair, you know. We don't need chest hair. No, it's not worth it. Neither one of these is worth it. I don't care about getting a fly item, and Big Fan just makes all the orbitals move slower, so I don't really need it. And as much as, I mean, you could make a case for Forget Me Now, since we did get a Krampus fight, but like we really don't need to do this floor again. It would make a little bit more sense because we have the golden question mark, also known as even more options, or even more options. It's one of those two. Okay, so we have Gemini. I'm sitting here waiting for our shots to pierce. I'm like, why are they not piercing? This game is broken. WTF, Tyrone. Ooh, I think we'll take Compound Fracture, actually. Compound Fracture is pretty good. There we go. The other item was the soul, by the way. Can't get sick, man. I can't get sick. Wow, did anyone see how long? Someone go back and count how long that freaking troll bomb took to, that mega troll bomb took to explode. That's got to be a record. I can't get sick and I can't lose my voice, but I think both of those are happening right now. One day I'm just going to wake up and like my vocal cords are just going to be gone. Not in the sense like the figurative sense, but I mean like literally, like they're just going to be gone. I will lose the ability to actually speak. And then my career is over as a streamer / YouTuber. It's going to be a dark day, man. One day in the very distant future, I'll hang everything up. But I'm nowhere near ready to call it quits. Nowhere even near. We haven't even made it yet. We're not even at freaking 60,000 subs yet. You know, I've got another 2 million subs to go before I start thinking about retirement, all right? We got a long way to go. Eventually, somebody asked me on a stream not that long ago. They asked me, "What is your goal? Where would you if you had everything perfect, where would you want to see yourself success-wise? You know, would you like to be rich? Would you like to, you know, live in a different country? What would you want to do with your success?" And I don't really have any ultimate goals as far as new media is concerned. If I could get 1 million subs on YouTube one day, that would be like I would feel comfortable in saying that, like, I think I made it, you know. I meant to take the negative. Okay. Holy light.
The stars.
I could have taken Roid Rage there for possibly speed not speedball but spun, but meh. If I could get 1 million subs one day, that would be awesome. But I mean, my channel has been around for a very long time, and it's just now starting to see, you know, big growth. Thanks to Isaac. And I kind of knew that my channel was going to be like that. I didn't know, but I had a feeling. Because it's my channel is just like me. I mean, you know, I don't like to grow super rapidly and... I'm not resistant to change. For me, change happens very slowly. And the same thing goes with the channel. You know, my channel is just an extension of myself, really. I mean, it's slow burning, but slow and steady wins the race. And, you know, my channel has been here since forever. Okay, well, not since forever, but since at least 2007, I think? 2008? Something like that. But I've never been more satisfied and more happy with how everything's going on YouTube than I am this year. Well, 2018. 2019 is going to be even better, I have a feeling. I just got this hunch, man. 2019 is going to be a huge year for the channel. Big year for Isaac. We've got Repentance coming out at some point. Four Souls dropped. That's going to give us lots of content, lots of fun with friends whenever they... shake free of engagements and that sort of thing. I'm very, very optimistic for the future of the channel. I will admit that doing the Isaac tournament is something new to me. Tournaments are not new to me, but this is going to be the first non-esport tournament that I've ever run. You know, because in the past I've run Here's the Storm, I've run StarCraft II. You know, those type of tournaments, but never Isaac. So it's going to be a little interesting to see where I slide as far as like the comfort level goes. Okay, brain, let's think about this for a moment. Thank you. But I think that once everyone gets really... Once the tournament starts, I think everyone will be like, yeah, this is going to be a lot of fun. I have no doubt. I really have no doubt that the tournament is going to be very successful. I don't know if it's going to do great numbers or not. I would love to see it do great numbers because I plan on doing it every single year. But I think that everyone will enjoy it. And at the time of recording, it's almost midnight tonight, and I've still got... I still have to animate, like, the versus screen. I mean, I've animated the hard parts out of the way. I made the template today. So I can, once I'm finally ready to start actually plugging stuff into the animations and the screens and everything, it's just going to be boom, boom, boom. I can knock all of them out. Because I'm doing what I didn't want to do, and that's go overboard with it, but I just knew that it was going to happen anyway, kind of what I said at the top of this broadcast. But... I'm always like, you know, if I do it, it's going to be done right. I'm not going to half-ass anything, so... Yeah. So, anyway. Anyway. Now that I've got the template out, I'm going to make title cards for all 32 items. And I'm planning on doing that as soon as I'm done recording this episode, actually. I'll be doing it on stream just because a lot of people really enjoy the editing stuff, which surprised me because I was like, why? You know, maybe someone can learn something. That's the only reason why I decided to turn it on in the first place, was I was like, hopefully somebody has any editing questions. I don't mind helping. Get the Emperor card. Gonna give us a one-way trip to Blue Babby. Also got Sack Dagger, of course. Sack Dagger, my favorite orbital. One of my favorite items in the game. Not a huge fan of us getting double tapped there. I guess we'll just head on up to the cathedral. Still no devil deal. So we're not going to have Polar Invincibility, although I wasn't planning on doing I wasn't planning on going to Isaac in this run. I don't know what we got going on, Isaac, but I kind of like it. I need to actually pay attention here, because we don't have a whole lot of leeways in terms of mistakes. Like, we get hit twice, and that's it. So let's hunker down here and really, really be careful. I will say our movement speed is way out of control. It's not max, but it's almost maxed. Big bombs. Bombs have been a constant source of not fun on this run. Holy shot doing work. So is Inner Eye. It's always great to see whenever Epiphora like maxes out with Inner Eye, it just looks like so much stuff happening. Lots of damage, and then you proc that with a faster tears rate, that increases the proc rate of Holy Shot. I'll take Vibrant Bulb, might as well. Completely forgot that we even had Bible Track. Think this is the right way? It's a big Soul Heart right there. Oh, we really just do a circle accidentally. Wow. Okay. Woo! That's some Sinvicta style navigation right there. We accidentally did a circle. Okay, let's find another dead end, I guess. Oh yeah, brother. Oh yeah. Can't go in there. We go north of here? No. Okay. And rock, of course, hoping that we get a soul heart, but we'll probably get a golden chest because lol. Oh, but we don't have any bombs. How foolish of me. There we go. Beautiful damage that we're doing right now. Another tinted rock, and surprise, surprise, we have no bomb. I feel like it's just happening now just because at this point. Us getting tinted rocks not being able to explode them is what I mean. Now, with this Emperor card, we have a little bit of peace of mind knowing that we don't have to go through the entire chest. But, of course, the problem is that we don't have Polar Invincibility either. So, as lazy as I would love to say that we could take this run, I do have to be cautious. This HP can go by, can just disappear very quickly. That's huge. That might be the run there. I just needed one more soul heart, and I'll feel comfortable. Two more means that like we're solid. So again, with Epiphora, I'm just gonna keep on holding the same direction, and the faster and faster our tears will be, our fire rate, our range is excellent, by the way. Yeah. I'm not doing delirium without Polar Invincibility. As much as I would like to be cool and say, oh, here's your payback for me accidentally taking the Polaroid. Yeah, I'm not going to do that. Eden's Blessing. Don't really want Eden's Blessing. Oh my god, he's taking Isaac's heart. Oh my god. Sinvicta actually took Isaac's heart. What is going on? Rah. Well, the only reason why I'm doing that is just because we've got an Emperor card. Don't worry, your old pal Sinvicta hadn't gone anywhere. I still hate Isaac's heart with a passion. So thank you for watching, everyone. Sorry about the little bit of a snafu not going to the lamb. But it was an enjoyable run nonetheless. Thank you, Black Juice. Thank you, Holy Shot. And more importantly, thank you, Inner Eye. Inner Eye showing why it's a It's a contender, even though it wasn't in the tournament, it almost made the cut, but you know what? I will take it. So thank you all very much for your patience throughout the tournament process as well. Once it begins, I promise you the discussion on the Isaac series will start to die down a little bit. And I hope you all have a great start to your day. Can't wait to start the tournament. It's going to be a lot of fun. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. And I will see you all next time. So long, everybody.